It was rumored that he augmented the number of subjects he photographed by inviting them to dinner and then poisoning them. His victims would fall into a coma and slowly die over the course of a few days. Unknowingly, their families would bring them back to the back to be photographed by Thaddeus. He died of natural causes in his room.
Someone's in my house.
Someone's in your house? What's your name, ma'am?
Jillian Clark.
Jillian, are you in your house?
No, I'm in my car. I drove down a few miles. The door's locked and the engine's running.
Good, Jillian. How do you know someone's in your house?
They sent me a picture of my bedroom on Facebook. This is the second picture they sent me of the house, and I'm really getting scared.
Understandable, Miss Clark. Just stay calm. There's an officer very close and he should be there any second.
The officer just arrived.
You're gonna be okay now. Try to have a good night, okay?
Are you Miss Clark?
Yes, sir.
Checked your house and everything is clear.
Are you sure you didn't find anything at all?
I'm sure we didn't find anybody. We checked it twice and there's nobody in your house.
Okay. Well, thank you for checking.
You are welcome. And if you don't feel comfortable, then I suggest maybe you buy a handgun for your own personal safety.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ah, what a picture. All of my friends in one frame. However, this was just a test. One here does not belong. But at 10:30, she'll return and we can take the real picture.
Supports her husband for her family's sake in making sure and support the
Carry on my wayward son, there'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest.
What is your name and what do you do?
My name is Mark Tompkins and I am a retired military and I still work for the Air Force. In my spare time, I guess, I like to write. Other than that, I write pretty much novels, short stories, novellas, whatever the story happens to come out as.
Why did you decide to become a writer?
I think because I just love to read so much. Ever since I was really young, I used to read a lot, you know. And I just have always loved reading. I don't know. That's all I've ever done, and I have the mind to come up with those stories, those type of things, and it just seemed like a natural thing. I have the dexterity, and I played piano for a long time, and so typing just kind of came naturally to me, and with both of them like that, I had this urge to get this stuff out. So.
Tell me what 10:30 is all about.
Well, 10:30 is about a girl that is haunted by a spirit that's attached to a camera.
How did you come up with the story?
Well, the whole story actually started with a picture. We lived in a house on base, and my wife accidentally took a picture with her phone. And it was a real creepy picture of kind of the top of the chair, and it was tilted, and there was a stair in the background. And we just thought it looked really neat. So the story kind of came from that. Once we were looking at it, we just started talking, and we were drinking some wine, doing whatever. And I don't know, the story just came out, and I had to write it. So.
Which one of your other works would you like to see turned into a movie?
Well, probably the biggest one is Road Rage, the first novel I wrote. It's an action-type thriller thing, and it was originally inspired by two things, the Isle of Man TT and an old video game called Road Rash. And people used to beat each other with chains and ride their motorcycles, and it just kind of was a story that needed to be told, and I'm hoping that one can get down. I need Quentin Tarantino to get a hold of me so we can work things out, because I think he would be great for it. His movies are awesome, so he would be good for that one.
Hey, this is my movie, okay? Props
Aimee's to me. Amy's movies are awesome, too. Don't get me wrong.
Thank you.